Hey guys, today I'm going to show you the workflow that I use to create a game model, and in this video I'm going to create a Magnum gun. But before that, I want to tell you guys about I'm going to make a tutorial series in which I'm going to show you how you can create your own first person shooter mechanism inside Unreal Engine. In which I will try to cover rigging, animation, and if you want modeling or sculpting of FPS arms, I will do a tutorial on it. So let me know. I will give some examples of animations. After that, I will export the model with animation to Unreal. So comment below and let me know if you are interested, and you can also give me your opinion on what you guys want for the tutorial. Do you want to get longer or shorter video tutorials? And also do let me know if you want to learn something else like characters or environment. I will try my best to cover your request. Okay, moving back to my video, in this video I'm just going to demonstrate how you can model your base model of the gun and will let you know how you can achieve some good results. Before starting modeling, I highly recommend you to do some research on guns, take a lot of reference from the Google, and then watch some reviews of the guns to know how it functions. It will help you to learn the forms of geometry and also will be able to model the gun as if it was used for later animation purpose. When I start modeling, I usually start with the body of the gun and with the box modeling technique and try to make sure that I follow a reference picture. The most important part is to make sure and pay attention towards the proportions you want to give to your gun. As if you give wider proportions to your gun, it will give a heavy look to it. And if you give it thinner and lengthy proportion, it will give you a smoother or slicker look to it. So it's up to you what you want for your gun. While modeling the gun, I use a lot of Boolean modifier to cut out shapes and forms of the gun. With edge split modifier and smoothness on, it helps me to make polished look of the base model. After making the body, I move to barrel, trigger, rail and the hand grip. And with some edge loop, I follow the reference picture to know where I need to give depth by scaling or by grabbing faces and moving them on axis which they are facing. For some parts, like the trigger, I have used solidify modifier as if it gives thickness to your mesh, if mesh is thinner as a plane. If you are having issues while modeling both sides of the gun, try to use mirror modifier as it will help you to only model the one side of the gun and let Blender do its work on the other side. To make your model realistic, you need to do a lot of practice on modeling and try to simplify the forms by studying 2D shapes and forms. Sometimes try to draw them on paper while looking at references. I prefer Boolean when I want to make the low poly, and after that I use knife tool to make boundaries on the edges of the gun, which later not only helps me to make a high poly version of it, but also is useful to easily bake smooth edges and details of the gun on low poly. And it's pretty much like adding an edge loop to a model, but with more freedom. Boolean modifier will help you to gain fast and some polished results, but use it wisely as a lot of things can be modeled without using it. Use it only where shapes are more complex, like for instance, I have used it for the designing of the barrel and for the revolver. You will later see that I didn't use it for the hand grip. As for the hand grip, I have used subdivide modifier and have used box modeling to make base model of it. For the aim point, I have used splines. After that, I just bake the high poly to low poly. If you want to see baking tutorial, you can watch my previous tutorial. After baking, I just apply HDR for the lighting. To make it more pop out, I use ambient occlusion and screen sprays reflection. If you want a complete tutorial on lighting, I have already done it. So take a look at my previous tutorial. I will share my link in the end of the video, so stay tuned for that. And I guess that's pretty much about it. I just wanted to share my modeling workflow for weapon props. If you like my tutorial, subscribe to my channel, and you can also follow me on Patreon, where you can get the high poly version of this gun. And for YouTubers, I'm giving my low poly model, so in the coming tutorials you can use it to follow my tutorials. The link will be in description. So thanks for watching and enjoy.